macOS Sonoma is available today. It runs on all Apple Silicon Macs and most Macs from 2018 or newer. I'm going to give you 7 reasons to upgrade to macOS Sonoma, including interactive widgets on the desktop, new camera controls if you use your iPhone for continuity camera or studio display, Safari profiles, better spotlight results, and a ton more. Let's jump into it. Number one is wallpapers. Now I know wallpapers might not sound exciting, but these aren't just wallpapers. These are also animated flyovers that as soon as you turn on your Mac, right here on the lock screen, you get to see these beautiful animations of scenery, cityscapes, and more. I also love the new design of this lock screen where your image, name, and touch ID or enter password is small at the bottom. You have the nice clock at the top. Then if I log in, the animation slowly comes to a stop and you have this beautiful image behind you. If you go to system settings and then browse wallpapers, you'll see the new dynamic wallpapers, landscape, cityscape, underwater, and a lot more. You'll see many that you've seen on Apple TV, but these landscape ones are just amazing. You can also scroll down to the shuffle aerial section. You can do shuffle all, just cityscape, or just landscape, and then choose how often the landscape is going to change. Number two is interactive widgets. Not only do you have these in iOS 17 and iPadOS 17, but now right here on the desktop. Before you had to do widgets over here in this today view or whatever you call that, but now you can actually two finger click or control click right on your desktop and then click edit widgets. Now you'll see a bunch of widgets appear here at the bottom and you can place them anywhere you'd like. Weather widgets, you can choose my location and then drag it around. And if you go into a corner and hold it for a moment, you'll actually see a little outline appear and it will make sure to line up all your widgets. One of my favorite apps is AnyList for groceries and they have widgets for all the platforms. You can see your grocery list or the meal plan for the evening. So I'm gonna put that up there. I can see batteries for my attached devices. Bayer Notes has some great widgets. You can of course put your calendar, and some apps will actually pull widgets from your iPhone using continuity. Now your iPhone does need to be in proximity of your Mac for these widgets to work, but they work. And so here's Chick-fil-A, and I can put this widget right here on my desktop, and then apparently just order Chick-fil-A right here from my Mac. Apps that also have widgets from both the iPhone and built into your Mac, you'll actually see the option here to choose, both on this Mac and from iPhone. Here for my home widgets, I'll drag this out, and again, you'll see kind of the snap to grid area, but if you want to put it randomly in the middle, because you're chaotic evil, you can do that. But because I'm lawful neutral, I'm going to put that right here. And then of course you can two finger click a specific widget and edit it. Right now this widget is going to automatically recommend accessories, but instead I'm going to turn that off and then I can add accessories or scenes right here from the search bar. Now depending on how many accessories and scenes you add, the widget will change shape and layout to accommodate that number. And the nice thing is if you want to change the size of a widget, you don't have to go and drag another one from that drawer. You can actually just select a different size and it will automatically pop out and resize for you. Now the nice thing is once you open up an application or browser window, those widgets will fade into the background, matching your desktop wallpaper so they're not as distracting. You can also run shortcuts from a widget, and one of my favorites, the Apple Podcast app has a widget. I can have my up next cue right here and click play right from the widget. I don't even have to open the podcast app. Number three, if you use your iPhone for continuity camera or the built-in camera on something like the studio display or your MacBook Pro, you actually have a lot more options for those camera controls and presenter tools. So let's say I'm in a video conferencing app like Zoom and I wanted to share an application like Preview because I had some pictures there. If I click Preview, now it's sharing that application. But if I go up to the menu bar where you see this symbol, there's a new presenter display option. I can click small or large and now it's actually going to show me on top of the window to everyone else on the call. And I can point to it behind me right here, or I could show myself small as like a picture in picture and even move myself around the screen. This way I can point at my own face. I can even put it over my shoulder. And as you can see here, now I'm overlaid and it's separating me from the background and putting the image in between. I can turn off presenter display and then stop sharing. And now we're back to a normal video call. You can also adjust portrait mode from the menu bar, and center stage has been improved and it should be a little better at following you around the room. Of course, you can also turn on studio light and now you look like professional. There's also some automatic reactions now, so if you do thumbs up, you'll actually see the reaction there on screen. You can also click the reactions menu and then add those reactions live during the call and you'll see them floating around. Kind of cool. And if you don't want the reactions to appear by accident during your video call, you can just disable them here as well. All right, number four, and this might be one of my favorite new features in macOS Sonoma, is profiles in Safari. So before we had tab groups where you could organize a bunch of websites in a tab, but now you can actually set up profiles. Here you can set up profiles, both personal profiles and others for work, and switching between these profiles will actually change the tab groups that you have listed here. If I go from my personal to my beard.fm profile, the background image changes. I can customize what shows up here on the start screen for Safari, and there are unique tab groups per profile. I wish I could access my profiles a little easier from here, but you have to close this sidebar and then you can change your profile back to your personal or another one that you've set up. Profiles are also great if you have many different accounts with the same website, whether that's Microsoft or Google.com. You can log in with those specific accounts under the profile and they'll stay logged in with that account rather than having to switch accounts constantly in the browser. Number five, there's better and more visual Spotlight results. If you search for a setting like Bluetooth or Wi-Fi, you'll actually get a toggle right here in Spotlight and you won't even have to open system settings. You can also search for a contact and you can take action right here from Spotlight, whether FaceTime, message, call, or email them. All right, number six, those one-time authentication codes that you usually get via text and your iPhone does an amazing job of actually just letting you autofill those wherever you are. Well, that now happens in mail, not only on your iPhone and iPad, but here on your Mac. And before we get to number seven, one more bonus reason to update to macOS Sonoma: you can actually share passwords with trusted contacts from your iCloud keychain. You can do this from your iPhone and iPad as well, but you can create a new shared group, choose your trusted contacts, add people in your iCloud family, or enter a name, email, or phone number, and then you'll see those groups here in System Settings. And number seven, you can create a web app from any website and put it in your dock so it acts more like an application. A great example of this is Threads, which you can access on the web, but there's no app for it. So if I visit the website here in Safari, I can go up to File, Add to Dock, and now it will become a web app. And now you see I have a Threads icon here in the dock, and when I click to open it, it acts more like an application than an actual web page in Safari. I can resize it. It's actually nice because I can make it more narrow than a Safari window. The Safari window just stops right there. And now it feels like I have a Threads app right here on my Mac. This might be great for project management software or websites you have to go to for your work that don't have native macOS applications but you use all the time. Web apps is a great way to access them and they feel more like apps. So those are my top seven and a bonus reason to update to macOS Sonoma. Let me know, what is your favorite feature or favorite feature of iOS 17 and iPadOS 17? I actually have videos on both of those, including 17 hidden features in iOS 17, like, did you know you could play audio messages at 2x speed now? Well, if you didn't, you should definitely check out this video up here and this other video underneath, because USB-C on the iPhone is actually pretty powerful. It almost like makes it a computer. Just check it out.